We will start our three-phase short circuit analysis using SimpleOrder. We will define three voltage sources in sine wave mode, and we'll define their voltages, frequencies, and phase shifts. We'll also set the resistances and inductances of the system. This would represent a power transformer in some simplified way, to then perform busbar forces. Currents are pretty high, so we'll select the values at 10 milliseconds and simplify them to 20 kiloamps for the two high side busbars and 40 kiloamps of negative for the remaining busbar. We will perform a magnetostatic analysis to the busbar system. We have three copper busbars. So now we will apply our boundary condition. We will select the borders and define a balloon boundary. Now let's define our excitations by selecting each of the objects, which are the busbars. We will apply an instant of three-phase current excitation, positive current in two of the busbars and negative current in one of them. So this last busbar will be carrying twice the current of the other busbars, but in the opposite direction. So now let's go ahead and define a force parameter. You need to make sure not to select all the busbars, otherwise you will get the total force of the system. You need to apply the force parameter to each of the busbars individually. Now let's select the vacuum region and the busbars to define a mesh operation. So we'll refine the mesh with a length-based inside mesh. Finally, let's add a solution and run the analysis. This one will solve pretty quickly. So now we can go ahead and plot the magnetic flux density. Let's refine a little bit this plot by adding more divisions and setting the quality as very fine. So you can see the flux density is mostly concentrated near the busbar to the right, which is the one carrying the most current. So now let's plot the flux density vector. You can see I'm only selecting the vacuum region and I'm not selecting the actual copper. That's why the flux lines are plotted in the vacuum and not in the copper. But you can go ahead and plot it in both elements, of course. Now let's take a look at the force results. So in this case, we go to results, solution data. And we can see the force for each of the busbars individually. So the force will be applied mostly in the x-axis. So we can see the busbar 1 has 124 newtons in one direction. The busbar 2 has 1045 newtons. And the busbar 3 has 1169.5 newtons. So if you sum all them three, you will get something close to zero, which makes sense because that means the total force applied to the system is zero.